The other day, I was cozying up on my couch, and my dog came up and he started cuddling on the pillow next to me. I started thinking about how cute he was, and then I started thinking about factory farmed animals. It just made me realize, even though I had already known this before, that animals just want to be comfortable. Animals are similar to humans. I mean, humans obviously have more self-awareness and more consciousness than animals do, but do we not all have the same needs and desires? A desire to be comfortable, a desire to be free, a desire for food, shelter, water, community, and even a desire to be loved. When my dog comes up and cuddles by me on the couch, I can't help but think about the absurd unfairness on the way that we treat animals as a society. We let cats and dogs chill by the fireplace, in comfortable dog beds, and even on our own bed. We walk and we play with them, we feed them, we scratch their bellies. They deserve it, right? After all, they're adorable, innocent, and loving, and they light up our day. But what makes it okay to treat our household pets with this much loving and kindness, yet treat pigs, cows, sheep, turkeys, and chickens as if they're inanimate objects that don't have these same desires? I assure you that these animals are just as loving and they have the same exact needs. But we pay no attention to the animals in modern day factory farms. Cold, isolated, and far from the average cozy home, these are terrifying places that are the equivalent of hell on earth. These animals are driven in a small truck, driven countless hours no matter if the weather is crazy hot or crazy cold, and they're not allowed to be fed or even given water on the entire ride. I've seen these trucks before with my own eyes. I see their little eyes peering out of the cracks of the trucks and my heart breaks. Once they arrive, they are trampled out of the trucks and on their way to the slaughterhouses where they spend months and even years in captivity. Some of these animals don't even make it out of the truck because of the terrible unsanitary conditions, in which case they are called downers. As they're welcomed to the slaughterhouse, pigs have their tails cut off and chickens have their entire beaks seared with a hot scalding tool, and they don't even have any painkillers. Chickens are locked up in cages that are the size of a sheet of printer paper. And pigs are placed in something called a gestation crate, which is a small enclosed little metal stall where pigs that are used for breeding are kept during pregnancy for years. They can't even turn their head, and the crates are so small that the pig's body is literally coming through the cracks of the crate. When these animals are ready to be slaughtered, they're hung upside down on a conveyor belt, completely conscious, dunked into boiling water until their death. All the while that they're in these factory farms, these animals, they know what's going on. They can sense the fear. They can hear the screams. They can smell the blood. They're not stupid animals that are completely oblivious. It's terrifying for them. It's a horrendous environment to be in. We naturally gawk at puppies, but did you know that these animals are just babies too? Pigs on average are killed at just 6 months old, and chickens at just 7 weeks. Cows, on average, are killed at 1 to 2 years old. There have been studies found that the majority of people trust in the meat industries, believing that the animals are treated justly. I think that even with the widespread knowledge that this might not be true, people still want to have faith that it is, but unfortunately, this is not so. The fact is that the meat industry is just that. It's an industry. And this industry cares about money over the well-being of the animals. That means jamming more animals into small places and not giving them any treatments or pain meds. They are handled literally as if they have no emotion or pain, and if they misbehave or even have trouble walking, they're beaten and toyed with. Chickens and turkeys are not even legally considered animals by the federal government. They're completely exempt from any law that protects animals in slaughterhouses, although the laws that do exist do not really encompass much and they are hardly regulated. You know when you get home from work and you let your dog out of the crate, how happy they are naturally to see you and get out of that small little crate? How excited they are to run around and sniff everything and play ball with you in the backyard? Well, imagine if these crates were half the size to the point where they couldn't even move, and if they were placed in them for years, that's right, years, without ever being able to come out, only then to be slaughtered. Imagine if your pet was kept in the same conditions as a factory farmed animal. They'd be absolutely miserable. You would do anything to get them out of there. Yet this is how farmed animals are treated. And instead of fighting against the system, most of us just happily consume them without question and even get defensive when vegans question the system and fight against it. What if someone were to take your precious pet away tomorrow and bring them through the same process so that someone could turn him or her into a burger? How would you feel? Not good, right? Of course, because we love them and they love us. This is exactly how I feel about farmed animals and how they are treated, because at the end of the day, they really aren't very different from our pets. No different than your neighbor is from you. We all have the same blood running through our veins. We all have the desire to be comfortable, free, unharmed, to live long lives. There are studies that have found that pigs are actually smarter than dogs and that chickens can solve basic math problems. So my question today to you is why? Why do we label one species of animals friends and the other food? Why do we treat one like a family member and one we treat even worse than we would treat our worst enemies? Luckily, there is good news and there is something that each one of us can do. Going vegan can prevent animals from being kept in these hell-like conditions. We can take a stand for animals and we can look at them with a more compassionate heart. Humans don't need animals or animal products to be happy. If leaving animals off of our plates prevents needless suffering and we can thrive on a plant-based diet, then I don't think I need to say anything else that would convince you that it's simply the right thing to do.